Welcome back to another edition of Funneling All Questions, also known as The Facts. This segment attempts to address best practices for our customers for your water, electrical, and wastewater services. I'm Lamont, now let's get down to the facts of the matter. Today's question that we'll be funneling, how can I improve on my everyday household water consumption? Some of the practical household activities I wanted to examine were things like brushing your teeth, taking a shower, washing the dishes, or doing the laundry. I had a brief sit-down chat with John Prevett, PwC Water Resources Engineer, to help me get down to the facts. Now let's talk. Joining me, I have John Prevett, PwC Water Resources Engineer. John, thanks for joining me.
Absolutely.
All right, let's break down some of these points. First, brushing your teeth. I know for me particularly, sometimes I am standing there trying to rinse off my toothbrush, or I'm putting my head under the sink to gargle, get some of the water, but it's just running. How and why should I improve on that process?
Well, although we here at PwC try our best to get everyone water when they need water, so when you turn on the faucet, the water is there for you. That water isn't there as an endless supply. We do have to bring the water in and treat the water, and it does cost to treat that water, to pump the water to houses, to install pipes along the way, that sort of thing. So it is important to be mindful about your water usage. And like you mentioned, one of the ways a lot of folks end up using more water than they should is in things like brushing their teeth. As you're brushing your teeth, if you can remember to wet the toothbrush and then turn the faucet off and then go forward with brushing your teeth and then turn the faucet back on, you'll end up saving a lot of water, a lot more water than you would think in just those few seconds.
All right, John, you lead me into my next area. So, taking a shower. Same thing, I'm turning on the water, waiting for it to warm up, standing outside, that water's just going. I'm not putting myself on a timer when I'm taking a shower. I'm sure that could help, but I'm just used to using it. And even washing dishes. Sometimes I'm old school, I want to use my hands. I think the dishes get cleaner if I do it by hand as opposed to using a dishwasher. Help me out. What advice would you share with me?
All right, starting with the shower. A lot of times when we are getting in a shower, we turn the shower on and we set that knob to the temperature of where we want the temperature to be once we're in the shower. The problem with that is we put that somewhere between all the way on cold and all the way on off. And so you're pulling water from the cold water supply and the hot water supply. And you're pushing that water in the hot water supply through that line, and all that water between the hot water heater and the shower head is cold, of course, which is why we're waiting. Here's a tip for you. If you turn that knob to where it's hotter than it would normally be, you can even turn it all the way to hot. I would not recommend that if you've got small children in the house because you can get scalded that way. But if you'll turn it to hotter than you would normally use during a regular shower, then you'll get more of that hot water flowing through that line faster. So you're not wasting all that cold water through that line. So you get the shower warmed up quicker, and then you can turn that knob back to the normal temperature that you would be using. It's also important to use low flow faucet heads in washing dishes. A dishwasher is more efficient with water usage, but if you are going to wash your dishes in the sink, make sure that you fill up the sink all the way and wash all the dishes in the water there, and then drain the sink out, and then rinse your dishes. If you're using a dishwasher and you want to be even more conservative with your water usage, don't pre-rinse. You can scrape the food off into the trash can and then put the dish in the dishwasher instead of standing there with all the spaghetti and or salad and whatever all over your plate and trying to wash it all off in the sink. Get as much of that off in the trash can as possible.
John, you're making it all make sense to me now. Lastly, when it comes to doing laundry. So when I'm washing white clothes, I'm putting the water temperature on hot. If I'm doing colored clothes, sometimes I change it to warm. If I'm just washing my black clothes, I do cold water. What would you advise?
Most of the time, warm water is fine unless you have something that's very soiled. I think most of the time, most people will wash whites on hot, just because it does get the stains out better. If you want to go with all cold water and not use any hot water to conserve electricity, you'll need to make sure you're using a cold water detergent. Although, be mindful that not all cold water detergents are necessarily eco-friendly. Also, as you're looking to upgrade your washing machine, purchasing one of the high-efficiency washers will help conserve water. And using Energy Star compliant washers and dryers also helps conserve energy.
All right, thanks, John, for the tips and the wisdom. As he mentioned, if you're taking a shower, it'll also be helpful to get a low-flow shower head. And for washing clothes and your dishes, get an Energy Star certified dishwasher or clothes washer. And those are things that'll help you out when saving your bill. Also, visit our website, www.faypwc.com, for more information and tips on how you can conserve. Well, hopefully this has been a helpful segment. Either way, regardless, these are the facts.